Today, Democratic Representative Seth Moulton announced he's ending his presidential bid during a speech at the Democratic National Committee summer meeting in San Francisco. Here are his remarks.
Hello, DNC. Thank you so much for having me here for today and for all that you do. I have only been in this race since April. I was one of the last candidates to get in. But I couldn't be more proud of what our team has accomplished over the last few months. We have been challenging Donald Trump where he is weakest, as Commander-in-Chief, and showing this country that Democrats are the party of making America strong overseas and safe here at home. We have been running to take back patriotism from the Republican Party, because we all know in this room true patriotism isn't hugging the flag like Donald Trump likes to do. It's fighting for what the flag represents. We have put forward the most ambitious call to national service in a generation, asking all 33 million young Americans to consider serving here at home to tackle the biggest challenges of today, like climate change. And this campaign has even helped me face a few of my own fears. For the first time in my life, I talked publicly about dealing with post-traumatic stress from my 4 combat tours in Iraq, about how I sought help for my post-traumatic stress, help that has made me a better public servant, a better husband, and a better father. And our team put forward a plan that will end the stigma around mental health, the same stigma that kept me silent for so long and that kept every presidential candidate before me from talking about mental health struggles themselves. That's what this campaign has been about, the courage to be honest about the challenges that we face. And I'm so proud of what we've done. But today, I want to use this opportunity with all of you here to announce that I am ending my campaign for president. Though this campaign is not ending the way I had hoped, I am leaving this race knowing that we raised issues that are vitally important to the American people and our future. I couldn't have done any of this without my amazing wife, Liz, and daughter, Emmy, behind me. I couldn't have done it without my extraordinary team, who worked incredibly hard for a long-shot candidate because they believed in me, in our mission, like they believe in our country. And I definitely couldn't have done it without everyone who supported me and came out to events and donated and volunteered for this campaign all across the country. Each of you reminds me everywhere and every day of what truly makes America great. From the bottom of my heart, thank you. While this is the end of my campaign, it is certainly not the end of our efforts. I will once again be running for Congress in the 6th District of Massachusetts, my home, and I can't wait to get back at it. I will be relaunching my organization, Serve America, which helped take back the House last cycle by electing 21 service-driven Democrats in tough districts across America. To work with all of you to keep the House, to flip the Senate, and to win back state houses across the country next November. Because those down-ballot races are just as important as a presidential. And most of all, I will be campaigning my ass off for whoever wins our nomination for 2020. Donald Trump is going to be harder to beat than most people think, but we can. And we must beat him because our country, our values, and our future depend on it. As a party, we need to spend these next months doing everything we can to determine who our strongest nominee will be And as we do so, we can't be distracted by the latest outrage on Twitter or the reality show politics of the day. We need to stay grounded in what it's going to take to win the trust of voters, all kinds of Democrats, independents like Obama-Trump voters, and even disaffected Republicans, and bring the country together around beating the hateful politics of Donald Trump. Because you can be a Democrat or a Republican or an independent, but as an American, you know that we're better than this. And we're going to prove it at the ballot box in 2020. Now, before I go, I want to say one more thing. My mentor in college, Reverend Peter Gomes, once said, "Hope is the stuff that gets us through and beyond when the worst that can happen happens." And oftentimes in these past couple of years and even the past couple of weeks, it's felt like the worst that could happen in America has happened. But when I traveled the country over the last several months, I found hope. I found hope in the veterans I met who are working to end the stigma around mental health by sharing their stories for the very first time. I found hope in the kids who were walking out of school demanding progress on climate change and guns. I found hope in the teachers and the reporters who are striking for basic pay. I found hope in the women who have been marching for basic respect. I found hope in the amazing, diverse, talented group of leaders we have running for president. And I find hope here in this room and in rooms like it across America, where Democrats are banding together through our shared values to beat Donald Trump and all of the Republicans who do his bidding, and to fight for who we are. You know, I often say that in the men and women I served with in Iraq, I saw the best of America in the worst of circumstances. In the midst of a war many of us disagreed with, a war I spoke out against, we always knew that despite the failures in Washington, we were fighting for each other. We had each other's backs. And you know, I've seen the same thing on this campaign. We believed in our values so much that we were willing to fight for them, and people like that are doing it across America. I've seen Americans from all backgrounds, all races, all religions, standing up and fighting for our values because they believe in our country, even when it lets them down, especially when it lets them down, because that is when the country needs us most. We have a lot of work to do and some tough months ahead of us, but we can do this. We wake up tomorrow in the America that we make. And I'm so proud to be making it better with all of you. Thank you very much.